I had a teammate fight. Ed Herman went out. He fought Pat Cummins. Used to be teammates with Pat. The Range Training Center, we used to spar, spend a lot of time. So I stayed out of it, right? I don't know how to handle those situations, so I just don't. I'm out. Ed, I will train with you every day. But I can't share anything that happened in the training room with Pat Cummins. And that's exactly what I did. I trained with Ed Herman every single day, and he's possibly my longest standing teammate. And this was going to be a dog. These two were going to bludgeon each other. I mean, I knew before this fight, these two are going to go bludgeon one another. It's just what they do. They're both good wrestlers. They both rather punch you in the face, and neither one of them minds being punched back. And that's exactly what happened. Now, this fight wasn't as long as it could have been. I would have predicted a decision, quite frankly. I would have predicted a very long fight. And Pat came out and did his part. Boom, 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 right on Ed's face. Ed came out and did his part. Boom, 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 right back to Pat's face. Ultimately, Ed was able to throw a knee. Oh, and Ed has good knees. Ed is one of these guys who was never a great athlete. And if it sounds as though I just insulted my teammate, man, it's meant as just the opposite. Ed Herman got to where he's at, possibly the longest standing fighter in the UFC. And I'd have to check that. I know there's not three. I know there's not three that have been in the UFC and fought for more years and found a way to keep themselves healthy, get themselves to the ring, use no excuses, change weight classes, do whatever it takes. I know there's not three guys that have been doing it as long as Ed Herman. But you guys really need to understand, because Ed deserves a ton of credit, not just for his victory last night, but for his ability to extend his career, his ability to stay around and stay relevant, grab the wins when he needs to win them. And it's through hard work. This guy's up early. This guy's in bed late. He's training all in between every which way. He's got boxing coaches and kickboxing, and he goes over and he's got his black belt in the grappling. Ed Herman works hard. When I talk about he's not this natural asset, he is not born with these big, incredible muscles. He's not weak. He is not born with lightning speed. He's not slow. But he's one of these guys that's had to figure it out as we go. And as the sport has evolved, and it has greatly evolved from way back in 2004 when Ed started doing this, it has greatly evolved, and he has evolved with it. Whether it's grabbing the younger training partners to make sure you don't get passed up, whether it's mixing up your coaching order, making sure you're getting more kickboxing in for this specific camp or more just Western boxing in a specific situation, whatever it is, going from a white belt to a purple belt to a brown belt. For years, he stayed at brown belt, kept working his ass off until he got promoted to black. I mean, this is a story of hard work. This is a story of one of these guys. Ed Herman came out. He cuts an interview after the fight. All he asks for is to be considered for the video game. The next time the UFC makes a video game, consider putting me in it. Well, that's pretty cool, because what he's telling us is, he's paying attention. He's seeing where the sport's at. Hey, don't forget about me. I've been here a long time, and I've done some heavy lifting. I was in the finals of the toughest tournament in all of sports, known as the Ultimate Fight, and I'm still standing. Consider me. And I love that about Ed. I love that he has goals. And they're not always what everybody else's are that's on TV and all about making money and getting paid and being the big fancy guy at the local club. It's not about that. He's a family man. He's a father. He's a coach. It's not about that. But he's got little goals. He wanted to move from a brown belt to a black belt. He wanted to move into 205, test the waters, get his hand raised a few times. And he had a bumpy road doing it. He even cut his finger off one time. Out work, takes a saw, cuts his finger off. Never slowed him down. Never missed a fight. Puts that little stump right into his glove, bites down on his mouth. You guys probably didn't even know that. I offer you that as a story. This is how much this guy does not use excuses. He cut his finger off. Really never told anybody. Went out and took care of his job. Now he wants to be in the video game. I think that's a great goal. And I hope it happens for him.